That one on the net, on the net. Oh yeah. Oh my gosh, Floyd's got a freaking giant.
What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another tournament fishing episode. It is the middle of November, and this morning it was like 25 degrees outside. It's supposed to get up to like 45, so hopefully we're gonna have a good day in the water, but it's getting pretty deep into winter and it's definitely gonna be a tough day out there, but we're fishing a big tournament. It looks like we have like over 20 boats out here, and we're about to hop right into it. So we are the last boat. I drew boat number 35, and definitely gonna be a while before we take off, but we're looking for 5 fish. It's a slot limit, so I think that it's 4 fish over 15 inches and then one that's under 12 or something like that. But stick around, stay tuned, and we're gonna try to get done today, guys. While we're waiting to take off here, since we are the last boat of the day, we're gonna talk about today's video sponsor, Karl's Bait and Tackle. If you guys wanna check them out, we just got a huge order in from them for a lot of stuff that we're gonna be using in this tournament, blade baits, Ned rigs, stuff like that. But it's an online tackle retail shop, and if you guys are a member of Karl's Club, it's $49 for the year. You get free shipping on all your orders, and you also save like 20 to 40% on pretty much everything on the site. So if you guys wanna save some money in fishing tackle, check it out. It's gonna be the link down below. But like I said, we're the last boat to go out today, and we're gonna be waiting for quite a while here. Looks like there's about 20, 25 boats or so, and we drew boat number 35. So very last boat other than the call boat, and we should be getting off here pretty soon. Water temperature is 43 degrees. It's definitely gonna be a tough one, but we're looking for some smallmouth, maybe some largemouth later in the day, and we'll see how she goes. But stick around, stay tuned. Looking for 5 bites and trying to win this tournament.
Gotcha. Okay, first spot of the day. I am absolutely freezing. Yeah, not even a long run. Yeah, not even a super long run, but enough to really just make your hands have absolutely no sensation in them whatsoever. But we're gonna be starting out with the Ned rig right here, working the main river channel, and looking for a smallie. Definitely icing up in the guides a little bit.
Is it?
Oh yeah. A little bit, not too bad. Okay, spot number one was a bust. We are gonna be moving on to spot number two. Cannot feel my fingers, but yeah. Out here grinding, trying to find the first smallie of the day. Got one on the death stalker, on the death stalker. Oh yeah, come on baby, on the blade. It's a good one. Yes, that should be an over. That should be an over. Boys, girls, first bite of the day on that little Catchco death stalker blade bait right there. We're probably like an hour into the tournament, give or take, and we should have our first keeper. That should be over 15 inches. Blade bait fish, yes sir. Oh yeah, 16 and a half incher. Nice smallie, probably close to 2 pounds. Okay, first one on the blade. Let's go, a little Catchco blade bait. Try to get another one. You got one? You got one? You got one? Hold up, hold up. Hold up. Come on, Floyd.
Nice.
Get one? On the blade, on the blade.
Dude, was
he was snagged and he popped it off of there.
Yep.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Oh yeah, it's a good one. Yes, sir. That should go.
Oh yeah.
That'll be close. Nice. He'll be close. But he should go. All right, hold on. All right, you take this. You got that. Let me reel this in here. Floyd just switched up to the blade bait too. So I caught that smallie, snapped off. Hopefully you guys saw that. I don't know if the GoPro was messed up, but I had like a big pike on, snapped me off. And then probably like 15, 20 minutes later, we just got second fish in the boat.
Yeah,
I'll toss him, but yeah, he should be a 15 incher at least. So like I said in the beginning of the video, we need to get 4 over fish. They have to be over 15 inches. And then we need to get 1 under. And that one's just over 16, a little bit smaller than the one I got, but another nice, beautiful smallmouth bass. Yeah, 16 on the dot. There you go, toss her in. Fish number 2 on the blade. Floyd got hooked up on a, what, you're snagged on like a log or something,
yeah,
and she pulled it off? Dude, that's nuts.
And I snapped it off and it came back and I was like, oh!
Yes, all right, sweet. All right, there we go. Fish number 2. Fish number 2 in the box. Fish? Good one? Oh, that's an under. We need that right now, yeah. Not a big one, but that's like an extra half a pound. We'll hopefully catch like
an 11 and a half, 11 and three quarter inch. That's really fat, but right now that's a keeper fish, guys. Very small, but when there's a slot limit, you can't keep any fish between 12 and 15 inches. So we can keep one that's under that though. So that's our underfish right there. We've got three keepers in the box. We need to catch two more that are over 15 inches now. Got one. Little guy. That one might be under though. That should be an under keeper. All right. I mean, I'm gonna bump him really quick, but yeah, that's gotta be like a 10 incher.
That's perfect under then.
Yeah, that's literally like just under 12 inches, guys.
I'm gonna put these on cult.
We should have been doing this the whole time too. Yeah.
We need a little net to scoop them.
Seriously, we need like a little butterfly net for like minnows. Jeez. All right, well, that is keeper number four. We've got two underfish and then two overfish. On the right track, a little Catchco Death Stalker is working for me. I'm throwing that gold one, and Floyd's throwing a little perch in gold color. Got to get some overs now, though. Got to get some of those fish that are over 15 inches. Going? Is that on the swim bait?
Yep.
All right. Floyd's hooked up. Come on, baby. Be an over. Oh, yeah, that's a good one. Yes, sir. That should go.
That should go. Dude, he's dogged it.
That's on the swim bait. All right. Yes. You can bumper to make sure, but that should go. We just made a move to spot number three and literally rolled up. Took like three casts. Floyd just hooked up on that swim bait. Probably another like close to 16 incher.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. 16 and an eighth. 16 and a quarter. Heck yeah. You should put a cold tag on that, just so they're easier. That is keeper number five in the box, but right now we have two underfish. We need to get at least one more that's over 15 inches, and then we'll worry about trying to catch some like 3+ pounders. Got one? Got one? Dude, that swim bait's killing it. Oh, boys, this might be the one right here. This might be the one. Oh, yeah, it's a good one. It's a good one. Oh, yeah, it's a good one, Floyd. It's a freaking tanker. Oh, my God, it's a tank. Oh my gosh, Floyd's got a freaking giant. It's a freaking big one. Oh my gosh. Oh, buddy. Oh, she's so close. Yes. Dude, that's a freaking nice one, dude. Yes, sir. A little swim bait action. That's like a freaking 17, probably. Okay, well, that is getting rid of one of our pipsqueaks, guys. We have got our limit. I'm gonna have to put a swim bait on and join Floyd. Oh my gosh. Yeah. That one on the net. Oh yeah. It's a good one. I don't know if it's gonna help or not. It might be a slot fish. Yeah, it's gonna be a slot. It's good. We're good. I got him. Yeah. Not gonna help, boys. Not gonna help. On the net rig. So they will eat this too. It's not just that swim bait. A little like 13, 14 incher. I got you. Got one.
Got one?
Yep.
Good one?
I don't know. It might be. She's running right at me. Feels good. Oh yeah, she feels pretty good. This might help, dude. Oh yeah, it's a good one. Come on, baby. That's a chunk. Yes. That's gonna help, I think. That's gonna help. We switched up to the little swim bait. Floyd was lighting them up on, guys. And ding. We haven't done any serious culling yet, just pretty much messing around with that little one. Yeah, it's like another 16, just a hair under 17 inches.
Yeah, that's definitely a call.
Yeah, all right, hold up. So we just put all the fish on the scale right there and figured out which one of these overfish is gonna be the next one to go. And this fish right here, fish number three, about a 2-pounder going back in the lake. So we've got two nice size overs in there. The one that I just caught was actually our second biggest, and then that one that Floyd caught just a second ago was our biggest one. Then we got our little under, and then two more overs in this side. So five fish, and we're just trying to catch another like 3+ pounder if we can. Actually, none of our fish are over three, but we need a 3+ pounder. That's gonna be the key. You got one? Good one? We're recording? We're recording, okay. We just moved spots. I just flipped on the GoPro. Come on, buddy. Literally didn't even get to take a cast. Floyd keeps just popping on the second we roll up on these spots.
Oh yeah.
It's a decent one. It'll be close, honestly. I don't know. I don't think it's going to help.
I'll weigh it without it.
Yeah. Oh, she popped right off. Oh,
okay, we're going
to... We'll beam them just to make sure since they are so close. I would say that three is bigger. Yeah.
Yeah,
it was bigger on the scale, so yeah, sure. Mm. All right. Floyd just made literally like a
tenth of an ounce coal. 2.02 for a 2-pounder going back in right there. Okay. Yeah, not giant moves, but still a move nonetheless.
Yep.
Always working for bigger bags. Literally the first cast up there, I didn't even get a chance to make a cast. Going, ate it on the drop. Ate it on the drop on the blade. It doesn't feel that big, honestly. Just kidding, dude. Yeah, those ones are.
All right, 308. You're waiting.